you make them as the OPC and then allow them to be LLP. Now, with no chance of your getting into public or private, with this 2 crores of capital and 50 lakhs of turnover and so on, business wise and compliance wise, I am not sure how far it makes sense for any professional to advise the client that you do this. Because after having LLP, where you are the minimum kind of compliant, at least technically, having the OPC just for the namesake, maybe not. Because professional, everybody is doing LLP and not OPC. So which people you are targeting? Are we targeting traders? Are we targeting some manufacturers? Because today with 2 crores of turnover, I don't think even a good person will exceed the 2 crore in any point of time. Maybe, I mean, 2 crore turnover, if you look at it, maybe 50% excise and service tax and sales tax. You may get only 1 crore. Maybe. So overall, one has to think that whether this OPC, as a practitioner, if I have to make some client to go, it makes sense or not. It's a good thing to instrument, but whether it really practically makes sense. Now, in OPC, it talks about the conversion. See, I'm coming into this incorporation as a major, it's a standardized what you require. The critical issue which OPC faced out because of the unique things which they are doing. It talks about within 6 months you have to convert yourself into private or public. Up to 6 months. And conversion will be if you enter MOA and AOA as per the section. Now if you go to section 14, it talks about articles of association. It does not provide OPC conversion. Okay, one may argue that it only says OPC means nothing but a private company. So one may take a view that no, this OPC is a private company. So it doesn't require any specific what you call provision into the conversion. Then how do you convert into private company? Then the question we are asking, if there is a specific provision and whole chapter of OPC, how OPC will be incorporated, how it will be filed over the how will you comply? What's the logic not putting a specific thing about the conversion of OPC into section 14? And I will come back why practically the issue comes. The most important thing is that there is no OPC certificate. Today we have certificate incorporation. If you go to that in 11, the standard certificate format. The format of incorporation certificate will only say normally that you are, they will nowhere in their bracket they put the word OPC. If you see the certificate form, it doesn't talk about the OPC. If you go to the memorandum notes, it doesn't talk about that you say you are OPC. Except in the subscriber page, you do say that I am OPC and then there is a separate page. And then nomination comes. So last page only is has a different things. Otherwise, in your MOA, AOA, or certificate, if you look at the format of certificate, I have not seen that it says an OPC. There is a limited. Now, practically, I feel that there could be a major issue for such. We know after we have an incorporation, when you go to the getting the income tax, you have to provide certificate of incorporation. Now, will your certificate of incorporation only show the private or public? I mean, private or public. Nowhere it mentions the OPC. In which name your income tax number will be issued? Because they will go by certificate, MOA. Nowhere it says it's OPC. How you distinguish yourself as an MPC? And today we know that department was there, very standardized requirement. You give me form 18, you give me form 32, you give me a certificate, and I will get you PAN 10. If you do not have on certificate or OPC name, actually I am not saying, and the certificate doesn't show, how you will able to get a PAN number in the name of OPC? Because these are different issues altogether. Even in the bank accounts, because normally they go by just you give me NYOA, give me to director, they are standardized, they will not go into that. Today, those who have worked with NSE and NSE know it. You give the document, they are standardized. Formatting, form 32, they go direct, give me certificate, I will give the certificate in that manner. So if the certificate doesn't have my name as an OPC, how I would prove to the world that I am OPC? And it's the other legal implication also. The second question may arise. Everywhere your name is not coming in OPC. But under section 12, when they talk about the registered OPCs and how you are to display your name and everything, the provision states, in case of OBC, in bracket they have to put OBC. So legally I don't need a certificate say that I am OBC. I don't have MOABC say that I am OBC. But if I display I have been bracket, I would say I am OBC. My certificate doesn't know that I am OBC. I won't say no, I'm not sure, but this draft doesn't show that you have there is a proviso, and neither is the proviso that you will issue a certificate in the name of OBC. So if this is the case, and you are not getting OPC certificate, how will all your business registration and everything? If you tell me which name, then how will you prove your identity that I am OPC? So somewhere, I am not sure, maybe they later you know that they are giving so much of clarification if somebody types out, but it comes automatically. I have not seen OPC. Any certificate, it comes, it's okay. Otherwise, it's a legal issue because form doesn't say OPC. So right from your PAN number, 10 number, bank number, everything, so they are not, you're not going to teach them the company. Like today, even after so many years, people are asking me why the company secretary of which company. You are not able to give anybody that you are OPC. You are still not, may not be aware of OPC. How will you do it out? And everything is going by your certificate incorporation. So this could be one of the legal issue which OPC may face. So when it says conversion, now when the OPC go for a conversion, when it says within 6 months it has to convert. Right. You used to do everything, increasing number of members to 7 members. And you have to file form 5 that I am ceased to be a OPC within 60 days. That is also due. No. The question may arise, day, because there is a limit provision, that from the day I exceeded my turnover or paid up, I ceased to be a OPC. But I have 6 months to go as a conversion. Now during this 6 months, what will be the my character? Am I OPC? Whether I am private or whether I am public? Technically anybody can ask the question. Like earlier, if you look at today on the side, we have a liability of members on your retail, if it is fall below 1 month, you know, 1 to 2 percent, and up to 6 months, after 6 months your liability starts. There is no connected set provisions which says that even though you are ceased to be OPC, your old status, everything continue up to 6 months till you convert. Now within this 6 months, what I'm supposed to do, whether my liability will be as an office, whether my liability is a private company, or my public company. I may decide even the 59 day that I have to now, I mean after 5 months, that I want to go with public company rather than a private. Since there is no clarity or there is no immunity as such, whether that one person, one member or one director will have a personal liability for any kind of liability created. See, this could be an absurd kind of interpretation. But knowingly that or how it is interpreted by different people, this may cause an issue if somebody were to create an issue. Show me that whether you are liable or not liable. What are you? Are you in coma? Are you alive? Not alive? How I do with this? So, these are the provisions where you require some kind of matching. Whether, I mean, see, it's logically you can't cut short a section at the halfway, don't link into the next section or clarity that, okay, these are the flow by which you will either convert it, these are the flow within between what will be your immunity, you will continue the obviously or something. So, issue may arise. I mean, today we feel that this could be the absurd kind of question. But knowing that there are thousands of minds and everything, people may argue this, Becky bhai, what is your status? You already ceased to be OPC. The word is you are ceased to be OPC. So the question may arise that why there is no language that but still continue to be operation up to the 6 months is converted. So when I cease to be OPC, whether I am supposed to close my business or I continue. These are the normal process we go and we know name reservation, member of association. Let's go to name reservation. Today we know it's very easy. You make sure that your name with all kind of combination A, B, C, D, to Z, plus, minus, also get all kind of stars in your, this is my good name. Because of Jyotish Shastra is my good name, and we give all clarification for getting name approved from ROC. You have to see that it is not trademark infringement and it is not similar to the other companies. Now that also very difficult because we are the 15 lakh companies and whatever permutation combination you do, somewhere around the you can read, but then you know you still generally you put some language. You put some word, you put some alphabet, and simply clarify. The idea was that you just be able to clarify the accepted upfront, and you then want to get the name. But if you go in the new law, it's not so easy. The same thing, identical symbol, you will not get existing name. So later on, I will come back to what will if there is a group of these changes. It should not be offense under any law. And that is also one of the most, again, this whole subjective issue. We know today what happens if you put something Twitter, if you put something like that, then IT law comes into play. All kind of thing comes in. Now, offense under any law, in India we have no how many laws. If somebody in Jubilee has opened up this law, what you put into your name, will it be open? I mean, because nothing comes in the picture that what is offensive. So it's a very subjective, very wide. That what is offensive, know that everybody will decide on yourself. So to the extent, whatever name you select, if you are that kind of idea, we can know, you can say this is not offensive to anyone. Otherwise, you don't know. Today we have various names in the name of growth process. But tomorrow I am not sure. Name, whether it will allow or not allow, because it may be hurting somebody's sensitiveness, somebody's so many things. So again, subjectivity comes in that whether names are allowed. That this is normal. I'm not worried about that. Now this is a, I don't know whether to say joke or not. If you are using somebody else's name. Today, if we are using anybody's name and we can say he is my relative, he is my relative. And okay, thanks. Now, if you are using third person name, now third person, I don't know how many Janak will be there in country or how many other people will never think. If I would use the Janak name, how many NOCR would be, I don't know. Because third person maybe tomorrow anybody will know he is my name. So if I use the third name, assuming that I say, okay, he is my cousin, and I get, he is my cousin. I will get my NOC of my cousin. Yes, I am his cousin. And I am allowing my this. Now still in the subjectivity. So then maybe your cousin may have similar name with other 1,000 people. So which NOC will get you? Now this was not there. Now more importantly, and everybody is concerned with this, if it is for blood relatives, I have to give the proof of relation. But tell me one thing, if I had my last wife, that I am using your name, you give me a relationship proof. What I will do? How long? What is the proof? Marriage certificate? Birth certificate? Somebody related to me, what proof I have to give? I have to satisfy. What proof I give to the applicant to make sure that yes, it is my relative. Now it is subjectivity. How will you do that? So, I mean, this was not there earlier. Okay, everything in this act, if you look at right from first and right then, everywhere they are asking them, give me the proof, give me the proof, give me the proof. Now what proof I give about my relative is my relative? And then, every word I have to justify, every point word I have to justify, that earlier I mentioned that I can use that, okay, is my lucky star, so I put A, or is my, I make it 5, 6, my cousin, and I put A, B, C, D, like that. I have to give the proof of every set of alphabets. Now, this again is subjectivity. What proof I give to them? I said A, Z, B, whatever maybe. I said any name I take it. And each and every alphabet I have to give proof. Whether it's fitting to my name, whether it's fitting to my relative's name, whether it's fitting to my third person name, which way? So each and every proof. And I'm telling you why. Because the language which we use is very difficult. It was not there today. About when you do false information and so many things coming up. The question they arise is all subjectivity. Wherever you get proof, I mean you file it out. And if you look at the new act, they clearly says it is you are certified, you are filing, you are responsible. So, it's a logically that what is the proof? And there is no, again they have given the rules, okay, you give me this proof. Like how they give, the subscriber has to be identification name, this residential proof. But here they say just you give me the proof. So, I don't know. What to make it sure that what is the proof I will give. And again it's subjective, because you may give one proof, again it will be different. The next thing, if you are applying for something, you have to give affidavit. And this affidavit yes or no, you can't say in between. That name which you are proposing has been not used in 5 years, last 5 years, in any of your any business. You may have sole proprietorship, you may have LLP, you may be as a mother private companies. A question may arise. Today I may have 5 business as a sole proprietor. I have good e-commerce business. I may be something that I am doing it. Tomorrow somebody comes and I say, okay, let's have a joint venture, we'll have a company. And I will use this name, this is a common name, so I will use it. If today I say that these are my companies, first of all, that means first thing is show that you disclose all of your transactions with the government. Wherever you are the business, whatever business, you have to disclose that this is name first. Then you have to say the last time. If you have NOC from such entity with a clear name, taking over of the business of God. Assuming you are a similar kind of business and now you are going for a company, I have to first say all my company. Secondly, I have to say that they are giving me NOC. So all the five people have to give NOC that I am using this man. Third, I have to declare that in future I will going to take over the business of these entities or not. Now this is a very, very vague kind of situation. Assuming today I am a president, and normally we know startups, they go with 4 or 5 ventures. Some venture may go up, some venture may not go up. They may have the trademark patent in one name, they may have something other name. Tomorrow you may get an investor. He says, okay, I will invest, but make sure that all your business get into your one business, you club together. Now, if at a time when I got a company, I said, no, I will not take over this business. And after 3-4 years, because of my investor coming up, I said, okay, I don't have much this business. Does this mean that this is the first shipment I gave at the time when I got a company? Because you have to give it now. That you will take over this business or you will not take over the business. You said, no, I will not take over the business. Then after 4 or 5 years, because of your need, if you try to consolidate your business and you are making one entity, will that mean that whatever declaration you gave earlier was wrong, not correct, untrue, or other way? For a simple man, he says, okay, no, I will take this business in future. But it doesn't happen. Then again your statement is true or false. What will you do? They may take. Knowing your government, they may take any extreme kind of interpretation. That you have given the false information, you will go. I mean they can say. Because today how can I say that I am going to take this company in next 4 years, 5 years? I am going to consolidate my companies. How are they? I am making up. So what's the logic for this? What they intend to do? And if because it's a yes or no. So you do this way or that way, you are going to think. Anything is true or false after 4 or 5 years. So if you don't do and you do, or if you do and then don't do, if somebody would take a statement that look, you made a statement these 5 years back and now you are not doing this. So again, this is very subjectivity. See, the question is there, something comes into the act. Something is putting into that. It is very difficult to say what is the logic behind this section. And if one section is there, whether what is the going to implication later on, if somebody would find out. Again the same thing, not an issue. But one has to be very clear. Today if your client comes in, all these things leads to that if you ask so many questions to them, and he comes and okay, this is my relative, this is my wife, and you ask, give me the proof. I don't know what will be the reaction. And after, I mean, again, I'm just putting it out very lightly, but I don't know what proof I have to give my relatives and everything. So before time comes, if you see the list of the things which you require from them, it may go to 100 items. With name, address, proof, everything. So, these are some of the subjective kind of things which may or may not, I am not saying. But this interpretation is they take in different way. And I am sure that there are lots of things going on. How is investigation, this is only. Now these small, small things they come up and they pick up so many things. You can this thing not correct. May not be today, maybe after 4 or 5 years, it was a bad one. Then rule 6 sets here. That today we know that there is an exchange of name between the two companies. We do it out and not much except NOC and NOC. Now they make some restriction. In way there is a requirement, compromise element. Then normally you can't exchange your name. Because we did it. Somebody's name changed, that name used by the other group companies, even without compromise element. So that kind of thing may not be allowed. So you have to be very careful. And particularly those who want they could do alignment and all those things. They have to put the brain to their scheme only that you have to change the name. Maybe because of court blessing, you do that. That is what. Otherwise, difficult to exchange a group name between the two companies. It is up to 2 years. So, let's start with the introduction. The idea of my all of earlier is that most of us, we have done it in corporation. We know what we file. The idea is that there is some of the new provisions, some of the new interpretation, which may or may not, if may not affect, it's a good for us. But if we will interpret it in different way, then what could be the liability for us? Right from the name application, moving further, what are the provisions? And then later on, I come separately for a foreign country where it should come. New information, occupation of any country. Here they also included students, housewife and everybody. Maybe because of some company has all drivers and other people. So they want everything. Right from student also. Applicant. Now student, how will they apply? That was one of the things. If it is a below 18 years. So again, you have differently, but they ask for this provision also. Then again, category, it's a normal. Which was not there earlier, now they have all this. In section 19 form also, what I mentioned goes, you have to disclose about your other partnership, sole proprietorship and NOC. So you have to be very clear, as a professional, that you ask this question to your client that what all business you have, because you have to include this. If not, then you have to get it from certified, this is my business, no other business I have. Because if you have another business, and later on found out, then being you certifying the form, you will be trouble. So list of this partnership or whatever the person who is coming for an incorporation, you should have all these things together. And then same intention of taking over existing business. Now all this thing is a part of your name reservation application. That means, and if you look at the declaration which you give, and I request every professional has to read out this declaration very minutely. It has a pure
if done against your head.
If you don't comply or anything, 447, 448. Then you see a PR there, after there, or anything there. But that is there. So every,
if you look at very minutely, look at all declaration, it's quite different.
All the forms, the certification, disclosure and certified person that disclosure he made. Very, very vague and very much exhaustive. So this is a thing, new thing which you have to do and form. So you have to make sure that at least you should have this information ready. Preferably signed by your client that okay, these are the my information. Because the new act is required your person that whatever you certify, you have to keep the record of that with you. So you have to prove that whatever you've done is right. So you have to keep the record of each and every document. Again, same blood related with other person, NOC, attached blood relationship. So what I'm saying is that whatever rules and regulations they mention, in your form, you have to get all these documents properly. And you have to make sure that you have these documents or information from your client. You will certify a water way to make sure that you are only going by whatever ASPM and not you are taking to it. Otherwise, there could be an issue for you if there is a certification, something comes wrong. Then another one, new one, registered trademark, NOC or application name. Earlier it was saying, are you registered trademark user or not user? Now we also want assuming that there are people. Because earlier we used to have even the website only, we say we are only a website.